Hello, sustainable growers. This is Jonathan from Melbourne Aquaponics. Today, I would like to talk about the best way of harvesting your plants in aquaponics. So in aquaponics, we grow a large variety of vegetables. I always recommend to grow the largest biodiversity possible because just to avoid the pests. But in terms of harvesting your crop, there are different techniques. You know, if you look at classic agriculture, when they grow lettuce, for example, when the lettuce is ready, they just cut the lettuce and they harvest the whole lettuce. In aquaponics, you got your aquaponics in your backyard, and that's basically like your fridge. You can pick whatever you want at any time. So what I would recommend you to do is not to cut the plants, but to pick the few leaves that you really need at the specific moment. In this case, you can basically harvest a bit from every plant every day. You know, you harvest the old leaves, while the young leaves are still growing from the middle of the plant, from the center of the plant. And in this way, you have a continuous production and you don't have to basically always harvest and replant new plants. You can just continue harvesting for months and sometimes for years, depending on the species. You got, for example, perpetual spinach, perpetual silver-beet. Those plants, they grow and they never die. They continue, I mean, they're going to die a day, but they continue to grow for years and years. So that's just fantastic. It's really decrease the quantity of maintenance, the quantity of work that you have to do in order to produce some fantastic, tasty and healthy vegetables. There are some plants such as strawberries that grow by themselves. You know, they're going to create new babies and they're going to spread around on your aquaponic setup. So that's also very interesting. Just be careful at not letting them just spread on your aquaponic setup, such as the mint. You know, the mint, if you put mint in aquaponics, sometimes it just spread everywhere. So here you can see that I got this little setup with a lot of mint on it that is growing on it. It's growing really well, but be very careful with the mint. Some parts of the mint are able to go very, very far. If you look here, we got some trescent mint growth, and you see how far it is going. It's going on the floor now. So you see the distance it's able to go. From the point there, it's able to grow, and to try to find new area to colonize. So be very careful with the mint in aquaponics, because if you don't take care of it, it's going to go everywhere. So here, when you harvest mint, just go very, very harsh. Just try to basically, each time you harvest your mint, you're going to try to maintain it. So there are different types of plants, of vegetables that you can grow. And depending on the type that they are, you will either go for the soft way, you know, just picking one or few leaves here and there to try to maintain the plant in good conditions and to help it to produce. But if it's an invasive species, if it's a species that is spreading around, try to get as much as possible, sometimes with the roots, to remove the whole thing. You just leave a little piece, but you don't want it to colonize your own grow bed. So it's two different techniques, but you need to adapt it in function of the vegetables, of the species of plants that you're going to grow in your aquaponics setup. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you are new to aquaponics, don't forget that you can download our free 6-step process training to build your own aquaponics setup from the description just below the video. Don't forget to give me a like if you enjoyed the video and to share it with your friends. See you in the next one. Bye-bye.
Don't forget to get your free gift from this screen. You can also leave me a comment below the video, subscribe to the channel, and see my last video. I really hope to see you soon, and I wish you a fantastic success with aquaponics. Have a good crop!